This, Justin, a brand new CNN poll shows the First Lady Melania Trump's popularity moving higher. Her favorability now stands at 54%. That's up from 51% from a similar poll back in June. Mrs. Trump recently returned from a trip to Africa, her first foreign solo trip as First Lady. While overseas, she did speak with ABC about her time as First Lady and got candid about her marriage.
You're not the first Lady to have to deal with her husband's alleged infidelities. Has this put a strain on your marriage?
It is not concern and focus of mine. I'm a mother and a first lady, and I have much more important things to think about and to do. I know people like to speculate and media like to speculate about our marriage.
You mentioned you still have a good marriage. Do you love your husband?
Yes, we are fine, yes. It's what media speculate, and it's gossip. It's not always correct stuff.
Joining us now, our White House reporter, Kate Bennett, who traveled with the First Lady to Africa. Kate, has the First Lady ever really addressed questions like this before?
No, never. In fact, this is her first on-camera interview at all in almost a year. She's intensely private, as we know. And during the peak of the salacious headlines with her husband, the alleged infidelity, she remained very quiet. Now, that being said, she canceled that trip to Davos, Switzerland. She was supposed to take, she took the separate motorcade to State of the Union, which we all noticed that was a big break from tradition there. She also took a few other separate motorcades. So certainly, the public could infer maybe that something strange or unusual was afoot in their marriage, but she's never commented on it.
What did you think of her answer?
I think it's interesting. I mean, she remains very unemotional. She doesn't lose her cool. She is maintaining that privacy. And it was interesting to me the way the country has been wrapped up in this and the implications with the payoff and other people, legal ramifications for the president. The First Lady literally said she found it unpleasant to have these headlines and allegations made. So, you know, she's sticking with the First Lady we've seen so far, holding her cards close to her vest. But interesting to hear her speak out and to be, quite frankly, you know, honest and touch on these topics.
From what I saw, and you traveled with her every step of the way throughout those countries, whether Ghana, Malawi, elsewhere, including in Egypt, where she showed up at the pyramids, all of that, she seemed to be very, very self-confident.
She was. You know, it's interesting. We've seen this, too, with her before. When she's outside of Washington, and typically when she's around children, she lights up very much. We're very used to seeing her behind the president as he walks to Marine One, and her face is sort of expressionless. But she was a very different Mrs. Trump I saw in Africa. Very happy, lots of smiling, even laughter. Of course, she was playing with baby elephants. Who wouldn't laugh and smile with baby elephants? But she certainly feels more comfortable, perhaps, on the global stage, away when she's doing her own thing. And I think that's very important to her because she is quite independent.
Yeah, she certainly is. And we're showing our viewers some video from the trip to Africa. You think she's going to be doing more of these international trips?
So we asked her that. We said, where are we headed? When's the second trip? And she said, let's get home first. Let's take stock. And definitely there will be planning for another one sometime soon. I think it's interesting, again, that she chose Africa as her first international trip alone, a country very much associated with previous modern first ladies, such as Michelle Obama and Laura Bush. Hillary Clinton made a long solo trip as First Lady when she was First Lady to Africa as well. So she's following in that tradition.
And it's interesting because there was political controversy. Her husband, the President of the United States, supposedly said some not so nice things about some countries in Africa.
Exactly. And the First Lady said she didn't believe those comments. She didn't hear them. She said that they were from an anonymous source and therefore not to be believed. She also said that none of that was brought up during her visits there. But of course, it sort of cast a pall over this trip. Also that her husband had made some budget cuts in his budget to USAID, which she partnered with on this trip. So there were certainly some Washington implications, some things going on that might have crossed over into her trip. But she, again, she downplayed them. So they weren't an issue this time.
In our brand new poll, which I mentioned, let's take a look at, dig a little bit deeper about the support for the First Lady. 83% favorability among Republicans, 55% among independents, only 28% favorability for Democrats. She's struggling with Democrats right now. My suspicion is she's struggling more because she's married to Donald Trump than she than it would be normally the case.
Right, agreed. And I think it really just is a party line issue here. She has not really made a strong initiative push for Be Best. People are still confused what it's about, what the focus is. There's still a sort of a relatively high number of people who don't have an opinion of her. I think it's at 14%, which, considering this far into her tenure, is somewhat unusual that no one can actually say whether they're favorable or unfavorable. She is, however, Wolf, higher than the president, whose favorable remains at 41% in the same poll. So she's a good 13 points ahead of her husband in terms of favorability.
And we're going to see more of her internationally, right?
I would imagine so.
What about domestically?
Yeah, I think she's going to continue to roll out this program. She's going to visit more schools and hospitals. I think we could see her raise her profile a bit within the next few months.
Be best.
And be best, that's
right. She better be best. You better be best. We all should be
that's
best.
That's right.
Hey, good work. Thanks so much.
Thank you.